Grasshopper walks into a bar. Bartender says, "You know, we got a drink in here named after you." Grasshopper says, "You got a drink named Stanley?"
All right, guys, so this was first thing in the morning. I am doing some neutral grip pull-ups. As you can see, I'm wearing a wrist brace on my right wrist. For those of you who've been following me, you know I had a wrist injury. I went to see the orthopedic surgeon. He said you had some torn tendons in your hand. He was surprised it hadn't healed by now, but he told me to avoid any exercises that make it worse. So doing those neutral grip pull-ups don't hurt it at all, actually. And then you can see here I was doing some push-ups on handles, and the reason I'm doing that is because I don't have to flatten out my wrist as much. If you can imagine, when you do push-ups, your hands are flat on the ground, and that's exactly how I landed on my hand and injured it. So if I have these handles to hang on to, my wrists don't flatten out that way and make the pain, you know, in my right wrist come back. So I was experimenting with these. You also get more of a stretch in the chest because you get to go lower than a traditional push-up. And this, actually, if you do push-ups correctly, you get a lot of core activation too from trying to keep your body straight. So here, more tire stuff. Now today we're doing some more or less some upper body tire stuff. Now, as you can see, planting my feet, or taking a couple of steps back, planting my feet, and then rowing this tire. And the advantage of this is basically cardio. I don't really look at this as strength training. This was later in the day as a secondary type workout, cardio type workout. And it totally takes the negative portion out of the exercise. So if you can imagine, like, imagine doing a chin-up where all you have to do is pull yourself up over the bar, and then there's no lowering back down. So you can see that it would make you stronger, it would make you be able to do more, because if you take out that negative portion of the rep, you can inevitably do more of the actual lifting portion of the exercise. So I want to talk a little bit about how I'm going to be changing up my diet here. So it's, you know, I've actually felt really good and really strong, and in a way, that's why I'm gonna be changing up the diet. I'm also not seeing the physical changes I'd like to see. I'm certainly leaner now than I was several weeks ago when I first started this series and first started this new diet, but I'm not progressing as much as I would like. So I'm actually gonna go back to an intermittent fasting style of dieting. So what my basic plan is, I'm gonna eat around my workout, either just after or possibly before and after, depending on when my workout is. And then the rest of the day, I am not going to eat. I might sip on some branched chain amino acids. If you don't know what those are, you can go ahead and look those up. But that's pretty much what my diet change is gonna be. And as you can see here now, oh, and by the way, that means not eating the rest of the day. I don't know if I already mentioned that. Kelvin was doing somewhat the same kind of thing I was doing before, his own variation on it, and now he's doing some straight up drags.
Earlier, we're talking about like working out. Like, the guy's like, "Should I? Whatever." I said, "Dude, you're a dude. You're a man. You should be fucking working out. You should be able to run towards the sound of gunfire. You should be able to operate a gun to kill bad people. You should be able to carry a teammate of equal or greater size. And you should be strong enough. You should be able to hit a man in the skull and make him a retard instantly." Yeah. Fucking Jell-O and crayons. Straight out.